that's not really
I
true.
know.
I make a, this is the argument I make. The argument I make is that where's the line? No one will tell you where the line is
Until it's too late and they
until
fire
they
you.
fire you, because
Right.
there is no line.
Right.
You know, it used to be, you know, in the era of George Carlin, and you know, you had your seven dirty words, and those were the things you couldn't say. Coming from talk radio, having done talk radio for many years, what makes talk radio work is having an opinion. That's, you know, whether, you know, and you hold to that opinion, you know. And no one, I see these people constantly getting fired for stupid crap. You know, it's like, because, you know, they said, I don't know, you know, they go against the latest woke thing or something, you know, and they'll say that on the air and they get fired.
You're fired. You're fired. You're fired.
You're fired.
Yeah.
Where is the line? There is no line. You can't tell me where the line is. And that's the problem. That's the real problem.
I'd like to think that that's pretty straightforward, like you're saying, but I also think a lot of it has to do with, because you get caught in this vortex as a broadcaster. If you own a, or if you're programming a station and you've got a guy who's being extremely controversial with his opinion on the air, yeah, he may be crossing a line, but he's also giving you record ratings
Oh,
at
that's how
that
you get
moment, you know?
that's how you get ratings.
So then how do you draw? There's another line that you can't figure out where it's drawn. How
Well,
do you tell the difference between
right. Well,
incredible
no.
ratings and
Though how you tell the difference is you have somebody that's running the radio station that understands that. And we don't have that.
Right.
Because most of the people in the United States, most of the people running the radio stations come from the sales department. And
Right.
all they're worried about is the next sale, keeping the sale. They get that sale. You know, what's interesting is Walt Sabo,
Or offending a client.
offending the client, right. Walt Sabo, when he was consulting the Rogers Group, I think it was the Rogers Group in Canada, the owner of the Rogers Group, which I don't even know if they still exist, but at that point in time, they were a big conglomerate of radio stations in Canada. And the owner told him, he said, "We will never hire a general manager from sales."
All I know is never bet on the white guy.
And Walt said, "Well, that's great, but tell me why." He says, "Because he'll just screw it up." He
Yeah.
says, "You keep them in sales. You care about the sales. You care about billing. Keep them doing that. But if you put them in charge of the product, they're going to screw it up and ruin it every time." And if you look at like the Howard Stern days, okay, the days of Howard Stern on terrestrial radio, Dave Ross in Miami. You know, I never really cared for the man, but he. When Stern would do something outrageous and he would get people show up at the radio station picketing, what would he do? You know what he would do? He would take them donuts and coffee.
Oh, yeah.
Well, yeah, that's what you do. You know, of course. You pay these people to have an opinion and to draw attention to your radio station, and then when they do it, you fire them. No.
All one has to do these days is take a
You want to
look
get
at.
that? You can get that.
No, I'm not going
This
in.
is not broadcast radio. You can do
I
it. You
should do this. You know what?
you could take a dump, you know,
I'm
while
going
we're
to
on
take
you.
this. I'm going to take this call and let you guys hear it, because I'm sure it's complete bullshit.
Okay.
Hello. Hello.
Hello?
Yes. Hello.
Hi, this is Linda Davis from Deaf
No.
America.
She's
The
recorded.
reason FCCA is actually eliminating.
Okay, I told you. I don't even have
Denied.
anybody I can talk back to there, so forget it. But so what I was going to say was,
Yeah.
all one has to do is take a look at Facebook for 5 minutes to tell how much of a ratings grabber opinions are.
Right. Well, I don't have a Facebook account, so.
Well, I'm just saying, even if you had to
Yeah.
look at a screenshot of one, you'd be like, oh, all
Right.
someone has to do is have an opinion, and
Right.
people will come flocking, you know?
Yes.
So
Yeah,
it's.
no, it's true. Well, it's the same thing with Twitter. I deleted my Facebook account years ago because I just I don't I Mark Zuckerberg to me he looked like a scumbag, you know.
That's a good enough reason.
Yeah, and it was like I don't want this. These people are evil, you know. Twitter is evil enough.
You were also a little bit envious of his situation, I'm sure.
No.
Oh, really? Okay.
No. No, I envy a lot of things, you know, but
You would have an enormous Schweinsteiger.
I tried so many
Not
times to get
that.
out of it, and I've tried so many times. I've deactivated. I've quit. You know, and then I find myself in a situation where I got to promote I don't know, a band gig or something I'm doing. I'm like, oh, damn it, I need to get back on there for something. But I'm trying to not be so addicted to it. What I'm really trying to do, John, is revert myself back to the naive, politically ignorant 30-something guy that I used to be, that used to enjoy life because he never paid attention to politics. And now I've become a miserable old coot because I know what's going on.
That's what's funny is that you on Twitter the other day, you were yelling at Brit Hume or something about something. And so I wrote you and I said, why are you so mad, bro?
See, and that's the thing. I just want to talk about the state of this politics today because it's so crazy. I was just listening in the car. Somebody texted me something about, oh boy, we are really headed down the road to fascism. And I'm like, okay. Meanwhile, at the same time that this guy is texting me, I'm hearing on the right wing talk radio station, which, by the way, 610 WIOD has become like, I don't know, it should be called like Hannity AM or something.
It's hard to believe that's the when I was there, that was Neil Rogers radio station.
I know, it's crazy. And now, so it's just those guys all day long.
I'm dying over here.
So as I'm getting this text about this wide characterization of the right as fascists, I'm hearing this guy on the radio say how, oh, democracy is over now that Biden's president and he's forcing socialism down our throats. And it's two polar opposite views of it, and neither one of them are correct.
Oh, you're absolutely right. You're absolutely right.
And people just go around town just thinking,